Hey guys, it's Grace. So last night I was playing the game Bananagrams. So for any of you that don't know what the game Bananagrams is you have all these little tiles with letters on it, and you're supposed to make a kind of free standing Scrabble piece of all your different letters, and you play against somebody else, and whoever uses all of their pieces first wins. So, but the way that we were grading it is the other person would kind of rate your puzzle based off of how difficult your words are. And so I always lost because, I mean, I lack those big words sometimes. But the point in doing that is so that we don't just use, you know, we or him or her when there's just a couple pieces left. You just tack them on anywhere. The point is to make it a little bit more challenging. But I was pretty defeated after playing it and always losing. So after we were finished, we smushed all the pieces together and they were sitting in the middle, and I was like, you know what we should do? We should make a new kind of game where we use all the pieces and make up just a bunch of different... Holy crap, there's a cat in my window. And it's black. Hey. Jeez. Where did that come from? What was I saying? Okay, now that the cat's gone and I'm less terrified. So what we did in our new game was we would create words that are not words. Like anything that would come up in our head that when you're playing the normal version of Bananagrams, you would be like, oh my gosh, I wish this word were actually a word because I would win easily. But it's not, because it doesn't make any sense. So I just, you know, started piecing all these words together. They sounded like absolute random things. But the rule, you know, the rule with my new game is that it actually had to sound somewhat like an actual word. So I came up with a bunch of different random ones, and then after I was done, I used all the pieces. I wasn't playing with anybody else, I was just by myself, and I used all the pieces. They were all words that just sounded like a bunch of crap, but it was hilarious to see what they were. And just for, you know, kicks and giggles, I went and Googled some of the words, and it turns out that almost all of them, I'm not kidding you, almost all of them were actual words. So one of the words, I'll list a couple, was Garfleck, G-A-R-F-L-E-C-K. So after thinking that this was just like, you know, Garfield's second cousin or something like that, I Googled it, and Garfleck is actually one of the names that people created for Jennifer Gardner and Ben Affleck. The most common used one is Bennifer, which I think most people would recognize, but I had no idea that Garfleck was one of them. Now you know. Another word that I created was Snurfle, S-N-U-R-F-L-E. And I was in my head picturing the like green version of a Smurf, but after Googling it, I found the real definition, which Snurfle means to like smother your face into somebody's neck, preferably somebody that you love and care about, obviously. I mean, I don't think anybody should just go around snurfling anybody. You'd get in trouble pretty fast. But Snurfle, you know, Snurfles are good. And then the last one, for all of your information, is Ziegerid. That's Z-E-G-E-R-I-D. And that apparently is a form of heartburn medication. So if you're looking for something to do to occupy your brain for about an hour, play my version of Bananagrams, which is just make up a bunch of different words that could actually sound like words, and Google them after you're finished. So without further ado about snurfling and cats, this is Dancing on My Own by Robin. Hope you enjoy. Like, subscribe, share.
Somebody said you got a new friend. But does she love you better?